And the same question will ask the each student, so that the biasness we have asked the same. So we can, so likewise we can taking the assessment of the and the final examination of the same in the patterns. So we have, when it was started, Dr. Rehan, Dr. Professor K.K. Sharma, he was there 15 years ago. No, this is the time we met here after the 15 years here. And Dr. Ravindran, R. Ravindran, when it was started, that C. Adityan and R. Ravindran was in the 1994, he has made all these things and we are following the same. So this practical, the problem based, where the all the system has, in the, if it is started, you can choose the some the problems, and the all the clinical departments, if it is involved there, they can take part in there, they can involve with these patients also, and so that the students can be the oriented, they can treat the problem based on that. So these are the things we are doing in the PP Corona Institute of Health Science. One thing I announce that for your the kids, nowadays, earlier when he has joined there, only one or two seats were there. Nowadays, there is 10 seats reserved for our institute, reserved for the Indian students, Indian faculties, whoever they interested, just like the Nepalese. So the fee structure, everything just like the Nepalese, so you can take advantage. Entrance is there, once it will qualify, 50% is the cutoff marks, out of 200, 100 marks is the minimum. If it is a 99, they will then come in the merit list. If it is more than 100, have opportunity, you can get, and it's a very, very nice teaching activity. If you have anything, you can share with this K.K. Sharma and the Rehan and the R. Ravindran, and you can, it's a beautiful college as well as the beautiful, the teaching activity. We are, in our department, 10 faculty, all are taking part in the problem-based and organ-based teaching. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ravindran. You
must have benefited somewhere through the lectures. Now, I would like to request the respective chairpersons to give the honor to our the distinguished speakers. So, please.
Very important like this, but many hundreds and thousands in future.
Thank you. 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 Thank you
Rightly, that's sir. Once again, thank you for your patience. And now invite you for the lunch, please, in the foreign hall.
Come on, speaker.
Other speakers are as well. Vikash Meni sir and Pranam sir are absent. So, Professor Hamad Usmani sir and Professor Anusuya Gehlot will also speak in this session. Also, Professor Alok Dikshit sir. So, we begin the session.
Hello, Professor. Sunne wale bulaya?
Bol rahe. He nahi hai.
We'll begin the session with Professor Vijay Mohanlal sir, and his topic is antibiotic rational approach. And so
Dr. Modgere ko introduce karne ki zarurat nahi hai, you will like to speak on the
topic. No introduction needed.
Now, if you go back to the historical aspect of chemotherapy, all are aware with the period of empirical, when no drugs were available. Second is the earliest phase, and today we are in the modern era of the antibiotics. Now, when no drugs were available, what was the treatment for this infectious disease? That was the post-damage, amputation, and other. Wards were full of septicemic patients. And that may be an infection because of so many organisms, Streptococcus pneumoniae and Staphylococcus pyogenes. Now this was the start of antibiotic era with the discovery of the drug penicillin by the Alexander Fleming that saves the life or decreases the mortality and morbidity caused by the various infectious diseases, and that many thought that time it is the time to close down the books on the infectious disease. Now this is the how the drugs evolved, right from the sulfonamides 1930 or 36, followed by the penicillin and all the antibiotic. Recently we have got others available. Now this is the mechanism of resistance, as very correctly said by the Darwin's theory, survival of the fittest. The bacteria then underwent a rapid, unprecedented evolution to circumvent this menace for their survival, and being a single cell and encountered with the ability to multiply rapidly, and changes were almost natural and spontaneous, that leads to the resistance of Now most commonly prescribed drugs today, you find 70% of the drugs they are prescribed irrationally or they are unnecessarily. 30% they are prescribed as irrationally. Now this is the rise and the fall as far as the antibiotic and drugs in 1900, you find no drugs were available, few drugs antibiotics were, number of deaths were more. But if you see the era of 1960 and 2000, the death rate decreases, whereas again the antibiotic curve decreases and again the death rate curve stood up almost the same because of the resistance building. Irrational use of antibiotics in the US, this is data available. And we say that India matches the best, but the best is not the best. So there is again irrational use of antibiotic in the other countries also. Is expensive the best for the same? You have to decide. This is the data showing the cost difference between five different popular brands of the ciprofloxacin. So many companies have produced ciprofloxacin with the cost of the drug varies from 20 rupees to 50 rupees to 100 or 200 like this. Again, cost difference between the drug in a single group, that is a fluoroquinolone, right from ciprofloxacin, levofloxacin, cost newer drugs coming, cost of the drug they are increasing. Mechanism of resistance and transport, there are different mechanisms, I will not go in details. So many mechanisms, that is enzymatic alteration, overproduction, in protection of the target site, and binding with the antibiotic, that is glycopeptide, these are the drugs. These are the new mechanisms, transformation, transcription, and conjugation. And the latest is the genetic transfer is called the trans for us. This is a mechanism based on the drug resistance organism that we see in MDR tuberculosis or extended resistant tuberculosis disease. Now this is a, though there are many causes we find in developing countries resistance, there are two important key factors. Either it is the overuse of a drug or it is a misuse of the antibiotics. And these antibiotics, they are frequently prescribed for the indicated in which their use is not warranted or not indicated, or it is the incorrect use of the drug or some optimal antibiotics is prescribed. Again, this is the antibiotic resistance cycle. Increased risk for use of antibiotic, increased resistance rate, there is ineffective empirical therapy leads to increased morbidity. Again, there is the use of more antibiotic. Leads to increased hospitalization, we are using more antibiotic, increased healthcare resources, that again leads to the antibiotic resistance. So this is the antibiotic resistance cycle. In addition to that, antibiotics are now included in many animal feeds. And these are consumed by our people. And again, that is among the important cause of the antibiotic resistance. So that is the poultry farm and all this. So what is the irrational use of antibiotics? It means the use of wrong antibiotic, second, in wrong doses, wrong route of administration, wrong interval and duration, and in wrong doses form is irrational use of antibiotics. What are the problems of irrational antibiotic use? Can be resistant to the antibiotic, can be adverse drug reaction, and third important is the cost of the drug. And intervention is possible and it should be an integral part of the healthcare system. There are different determinants in the irrational use of the antibiotic. It can be physician related, maybe a lack of knowledge or over knowledge, delayed lab results, fear of clinical failure, inappropriate peer norms, local medical cultures, economic incentive, and patient demand of quick fix. Patients sometimes demand that there should be an immediate relief when we are prescribing the antibiotic, which is not at all needed. On the other part of is that, that is on the pharmacist or on the dispenser, again, there is the economic incentives, lack of regulations and enforcement as far as India is concerned, unclear role of health providers. The major role on the part of patient, lack of access to proper healthcare system, belief and traditions going on since long, marketing pressure and economic consideration is again responsible. On the part of the policy makers and regulators, lack of rational drug policy and regulations in India, uncontrolled marketing tactics and lack of infrastructure is on the part of ministry. These are the four keys of irrational use of antibiotics. One is the lack of education, suboptimal approach to diagnose